the Lord.
Amen.
Father, Brother Dick has it. Woman, you're slipping up, baby.
Okay.
She has it. Okay. Exodus 15:26. If you diligently heed the voice of the Lord your God and do what is right in his sight, give ear to his commandments and keep all of his statutes, I will put none of these diseases on you which I have brought in the Egyptians, but I am the Lord who heals you. Now, again, we see that God promised if the people obeyed him, they would suffer from none of the diseases that plagued the Egyptians. See, God's commandments and laws are designed to protect us. A lot of people, when they read the word, they think God trying to take something from them. But God is always trying to show us a better way. He's always trying to bless us. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Many of God's moral laws are designed to keep people from sickness. For example, abstaining from fornication and prostitution can protect people from venereal diseases and even death in the case of HIV. If we want God to take care of us, we need to submit to his instructions for living.
Amen.
Now, in this verse we just read, we see that God lays down certain conditions for walking in divine health. Number one, he says, listen carefully to his voice. If you would diligently heed his voice. How do we do this? By reading and spending time in his word. You got to remember that God's logos word, a written word, was first of all a rhema word. It was a spoken word. Amen?
Amen.
And his laws are designed to keep us from harm. The fourth chapter of Proverbs tells us to attend to his word. Pay attention to the word of God. Pay attention when you come here to church on Sunday. Don't come here to go to sleep. Don't come here to use the text on your telephone. Don't come here to talk to somebody about what you're going to have in the buffet. Pay attention to his word.
Amen.
Incline your ear to his fans. Amen?
Amen.
We have to listen carefully to what God has to say.
Amen.
The next thing this verse tells us to do in order to walk in divine health is to do what's right in God's sight. God's word outlines and shows us how God wants us to live. When we get saved and make Jesus Christ Lord over our lives, we are saying in essence that we're going to do God's will, brother-in-law, and we're going to do it his way. Amen? That means we got to crucify the flesh. That means we're going to have to die to our own selfish desires. Amen? That means we're going to have to renew our minds with the word of God. See, a lot of times we're doubt of some things, but we still want to have control of others. But no, when you do things his way, you got to yield your whole body, spirit and soul, to God. Amen?
Amen.
I remember the song we used to sing, I surrender all.
Yeah.
Well, that's what you have to do. The third thing this verse tells us to do ties into what we already said, and that is we have to obey his commandments and statutes. If God says forgive, forgive.
That's right.
If God says to pray for your enemies, you don't question God. You don't say, God, you don't know what they did to me. You just do what God says. You just do it. If God says to abstain from fornication, then you don't have sex with somebody that you're not married to.
Amen.
Amen. God's conditions are very clear. He leaves no room for doubt, but we have to obey his commandments and keep all of his statutes. A lot of people don't know the will of God because they don't spend time in the word. His word is his will. Amen?
Amen.
Let's look at Proverbs 2:6. Proverbs, the second chapter, we're going to look at verse 6. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And it reads, for the Lord gives wisdom. Out of his mouth comes knowledge and understanding. God gives wisdom to those who ask and seek his advice. If you ask the Lord, he'll give it to you.
Amen.
If you are unsure about something, just ask God. What does Jeremiah 33:3 say? Call on me, and I will answer you and show you great and mighty things that you don't know. See, you can call on God anytime. Amen?
Amen.
If you don't want to call on him, you can go to www.bible.com and you can read all about it.
Amen.
He makes himself available to us. Amen?
Amen.
But we don't have any excuse about knowing his will. read his word and you'll know his will. Let's look at James 1 and 5. James chapter 1 verse 5. God has everything we need to walk in victory, and he has made all of that available to us. Mm-hmm. James 1 and 5. And it reads, if any of you like wisdom, let him ask of God that giveth to all men liberally and upbraideth not, and it shall be given him. The New Living Translation says, if you need wisdom, ask our generous God, and he will give it to you. He will not rebuke you for asking. God wants us to come to him. He wants us to inquire of him. See, wisdom is not just knowledge. It's the ability to make wise decisions. It's the ability to make wise decisions, especially in difficult circumstances.
Amen.
I'm reminded of Solomon and how wise he was. And when the two women came and they were claiming the baby, but he had wisdom. So Solomon said, I tell you what, we just cut the baby in half. But the real mother came forward and said, no. But see, that was wisdom, to know what to do when both of them were claiming that the baby belonged to them. We have to have wisdom. Amen?
Amen.
An intelligent person may have a lot of good ideas, but a wise person knows how to put those ideas into action. When we need wisdom, we can ask God. He will generously supply what we need when we ask him in faith. See, some people run away from doing the will of God, just like Jonah did, and they end up in trouble, just like Jonah did. Amen?
Amen.
So we might as well make up our mind that it's better to obey than run away.
Amen.
Faith for healing is based on the knowledge of God's will. The more you see healing in his word, the more you see that divine health is his plan for us, the stronger your faith will become. We have to listen and obey God's voice. Jesus said, my sheep hear my voice, and they obey me, and they follow me. Amen?
Amen.
We have to do what is right in God's sight. Let's look at Proverbs 16. Proverbs 16, you have to get your priorities in order. You have to choose who you're going to serve. Can't serve everybody.
Nope.
Amen? You got to serve God.
Right.
Proverbs 16:25. God's perfect will is divine health for his children. Proverbs 16:25 says, there is a way that seemeth right unto a man, but the end thereof are the ways of death. Proverbs 14:12 says the same thing. There is a way that seemeth right unto a man, but the end thereof are the ways of death. See, there are people that openly refuse to do what the Word of God says. I say that they don't let the Bible get in the way of what they believe. Mm-hmm. That's a sad place to be, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
They seem to think that they are smarter than the God of the universe. Mm-hmm. They think that their way is right. If you are not obeying the God of heaven, then you are obeying the God of this world, who is the devil. Amen. See, we sing that song by Ron Canole. Is that how you say his name? Ron Canole, going up to the high places, and we get to the part about you either on the Lord's side or you're on the devil's side. There is no middle ground.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. The choice is yours. As believers, we have to do what is right in God's sight. There is no wisdom above the wisdom of God. Man's way may seem right, but the end thereof are the ways of death.
Okay.
Let's look at Judges. Judges, the 21st chapter. Judges is between Joshua and Ruth. So if you see Joshua and Ruth, Judges is smack dab in the middle. Judges 21:25. When you get there, say amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. We got Bible scholars in here.
Oh, my.
We got one on mine. We'll give on mine a minute. Judges 21:25. And it reads, in those days, there was no king in Israel. Every man did that which was right in his own eyes. Now, you know that was one big old mess.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Everybody doing their own thing. During the time of the judges, the Israelites had all kinds of problems. But everyone became their own authority and acted on what they wanted to do. They acted on their own opinions of right and wrong instead of doing what was right in God's sight. Now, the world is bad enough today as it is, but imagine how much worse it would be if we didn't have policemen and laws and law enforcement officers to bring those laws to pass. Well, this is what was going on in Israel. Everybody was doing their own thing. And in today's world, we have groups and we have societies that make up their own rules without reference to God. They do things their own way. You have cults where a man has several wives and they all live together like one big old happy family. Amen? Now, you know there ain't no one big old happy family. It's hard to get along with one wife, according to my husband. Amen? So imagine a man that have a whole lot of wives. Amen? But you know, this seems right to them. There is a way that seemeth right to a man.